Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss about opamp as differential amplifier or subtractor. The topics covered in this video are opamp as differential amplifier, we will discuss construction and voltage gain, applications of differential amplifier, impedance of differential amplifier, and finally we will solve some examples on differential amplifier. The input stage of an opamp is differential amplifier stage. A differential amplifier can accept two input signals and amplifies the difference between these two input signals. The open loop voltage gain of an opamp is very high. Therefore, an extremely small input voltage drives the opamp into saturated output stage. Because of this reason, opamp is almost always operated with negative feedback. So far, we have discussed inverting and non-inverting configurations of opamp. Both these configurations uses negative feedback to control gain. We have already discussed above their voltage gain equations. In both these configurations, single-ended input is used, while the other input is connected to ground potential. Now we will discuss what happens when we apply input signals to both inputs at a time, and also observe how this configuration acts as a differential amplifier. The differential amplifier shown in this circuit is a combination of both inverting and non-inverting amplifiers. If the non-inverting terminal is connected to ground, this circuit operates as inverting amplifier. Similarly, if the inverting input is connected to ground, this circuit operates as non-inverting amplifier. So, here to find out output voltage, we use superposition theorem. We consider one input voltage at a time, and later on we will add individual responses to get final output. Vout is equal to Vout1 plus Vout2. Here Vout1 is because of input voltage V1 and Vout2 is because of input voltage V2. So first consider V1 is acting alone and V2 is at ground potential. Because of inverting configuration, Vout1 is equal to minus R2 by R1 multiplied by V1. Now let's consider V2 is acting alone and V1 is at ground potential. Because of non-inverting configuration, Vout2 is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by V2. So our final Vout is equal to minus R2 by R1 multiplied by V1 plus 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by V2. If gain of both inverting and non-inverting configurations are equal, let's say minus R2 by R1 is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1, then Vout becomes Vout2 minus Vout1. This negative sign in Vout1 is because of Vout1 is inverting configuration and there is 180 degrees phase reversal with respect to its input V1. Now let's make these both gains are equal value. We can write 1 plus R2 by R1 as R1 plus R2 by R1. Here to get this value R2 by R1, we need to multiply this value by R2 by R1 plus R2. So we can get R2 by R1. So here instead of applying V2 directly to the non-inverting terminal, we will apply this input through voltage divider circuit of R2 by R1 plus R2. So our input voltage at the non-inverting terminal will get reduced and also non-inverting gain becomes equal to the inverting gain. So our differential amplifier circuit becomes like this. Here we are applying input voltage V2 through voltage divider circuit made by the resistors R1 and R2. Note that both these resistors at inverting and non-inverting terminals are of equal value to get equal gain. So here our input signal V2 is reduced by voltage divider circuit and actual voltage at non-inverting terminal, let's say VA. So the value of VA is the voltage drop across resistor R2. So according to voltage divider rule, VA is equal to R2 divided by total resistance R1 plus R2 multiplied by input voltage V2. So let's apply superposition theorem here to find out final output Vout. So let's consider V2 is acting alone and V1 is at ground potential. So Vout2 is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by VA. Here we can write 1 plus R2 by R1 as R1 plus R2 by R1 and multiplied by, here we can write VA as R2 by R1 plus R2 multiplied by V2. And we can simplify this equation and our new equation becomes R2 by R1 multiplied by V2. Now let's consider both V1 and V2 are acting simultaneously. Then our Vout is equal to minus R2 by R1 multiplied by V1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by V2. Here we can simplify this equation as R2 by R1 multiplied by V2 minus V1. So if all the resistors in this differential amplifier circuit is equal ohmic value, that is both these resistors R1 equal to R2, then this circuit will become a unity gain differential amplifier. Then the output expression Vout is equal to V2 minus V1. Now we will discuss some applications of differential amplifier. A differential amplifier circuit is very useful op-amp circuit since it can be configured to either add or subtract input voltages. By suitably adding more resistors in parallel with the input resistors, one of the most common way of doing this is to connect a resistive bridge, commonly called as Wheatstone bridge, to the input of the amplifier as shown here. The differential amplifier circuit now becomes a differential voltage comparator by comparing input voltages. Here one input is connected to the fixed reference voltage and all the resistors are of equal value. And one resistor is light dependent resistor or resistance temperature detector to detect either intensity of light or temperature level. The bridge is balanced in normal condition. Then input voltage V1 is equal to V2. If the temperature or intensity of light increases, then the resistance of RTD or LDR also changes. Then the voltage at input V2 will also change. So the output voltage becomes a linear function of the changes in the active leg of the resistive bridge. This is how the differential circuit is used to detect either temperature level or intensity of light. This type of configuration can also be used to find out unknown resistance in the resistive bridge network. Here in this circuit, a fixed reference voltage V1 is applied to the non-inverting input through R1 and R2 voltage divider network. The inverting terminal is connected to a light dependent resistor. As the intensity of the light changes, the resistance value of LDR will also changes. So as the input voltage V2 is also varies, that produces an output voltage of LM324 which turns on the transistor TR1. So as the relay coil gets 0 volt, as the other end of the relay coil already connected to supply, so it turns on the relay. This is how light activated differential amplifier circuit can be used to turn on off the output relay. The same circuit can also be used to detect the variations in temperature by replacing the LDR by RTD. One of the major limitations of the differential amplifier is that its input impedance is very low as compared to the other operational amplifier configurations. The input impedance of differential amplifier depends on the values of R1 and R2. Input impedance at inverting terminal is the value of R1 and input impedance at non-inverting terminal is the value of R1 plus R2. So Zin is equal to 2 into R1. Each input voltage source has to drive current through input resistance which has less overall impedance than that of the op-amp input alone. This may be good for low impedance sources, but for high impedance sources, the source might get loaded. The solution for the low input impedance is quite simple. All we need to do is by using a buffer or voltage follower before each input voltage signal. As the input impedance of buffer is very high, we can avoid the loading of source voltages. But in practical cases, where you are dealing with small input signals, instead of differential amplifier, instrumentation amplifier is used. Instrumentation amplifiers are very high gain differential amplifiers which have very high input impedance, mainly used to amplify very small differential signals from sensors like thermocouples or current sensing devices. Now we will discuss some examples. Find out the output voltage for the differential amplifier circuit shown in this figure. When V1 is 1 volt peak to peak and V2 is 10 volt peak to peak. So first we will consider V1 is acting alone and V2 is at ground potential. By doing like this, this circuit becomes an inverting configuration. So Vout1 is equal to minus R2 by R1 multiplied by V1. That equals to minus 10 kilo ohm divided by 2 kilo ohm multiplied by 1 volt peak to peak. That gives minus 5 volt peak to peak output. Now we will consider V2 is acting alone and V1 is at ground potential. Then this circuit becomes a non-inverting configuration. So Vout2 is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1 multiplied by V plus. This V plus is voltage at this node. That equals to 1 plus 10 kilo ohm divided by 2 kilo ohm multiplied by V plus. That equals to 6 multiplied by, here we apply voltage divider rule to find out V plus. 8 kilo ohm divided by 8 plus 2 kilo ohm multiplied by 10 volt peak to peak. That equal to 6 multiplied by 8. That gives 48 volt peak to peak output. So Vout is equal to Vout2 minus Vout1. That equals to 48 volt peak to peak minus 5 volt peak to peak. That gives 43 volt peak to peak output. Since our supply voltage is plus and minus 15 volt, so output gets saturated at plus and minus 15 volt. So the differential amplifier circuit gives 30 volt peak to peak output voltage instead of 43 volt peak to peak. Find out the output voltage for the differential circuit shown here. When two input voltages 2 volt and 3 volt applied at inverting terminal and two input voltages 4 volt and 5 volt applied at non-inverting terminal. First we will consider the voltages at inverting terminal is acting alone and non-inverting terminal is at ground potential. So the circuit acts as an inverting summing amplifier. So Vout1 is equal to minus Rf by Rin multiplied by V1 plus V2. That is equal to minus 10 kilo ohm divided by 2 kilo ohm multiplied by V1 plus V2 is equal to 2 plus 3 volt. That is equal to 5 volt. That gives minus 25 volt output. Now we will consider the voltages at non-inverting terminal are acting alone and inverting terminal is at ground potential. So the circuit acts as non-inverting summing amplifier. Here we have to consider two things. Our Rin becomes 1 kilo ohm because parallel combination of two 2 kilo ohm resistors. And second one, we have to find out voltage at this node. Let's say V plus. To find out V plus, let's consider one voltage is acting alone and the other one is at ground potential. So our non-inverting summing amplifier circuit becomes like this. Using the concept of voltage divider rule, we can find out responses for both 4 volt and 5 volt. Or in other way, we can consider it as 3 input non-inverting summing amplifier, which has equal values of resistors R1, R2, R3. So the voltage at this node V plus is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 divided by 3. So here our V plus is 3 volts. Now Vout2 is equal to 1 plus Rf by Rin multiplied by V plus. Let's insert the values. Vout2 is equal to 1 plus 10 kilo ohm divided by 1 kilo ohm multiplied by 3 volt. That gives 33 volts as output. Therefore, differential output voltage Vout is equal to Vout2 minus Vout1. That equals to 33 volts divided by 25 volts. That gives 8 volts output of this differential amplifier. Thus all above opamp as differential amplifier or subtractor. So if you have any doubt, do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching this video. If you have learned from this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. My next video is opamp as integrator. Have a nice day.